teeth in the bowels of a hidden bunker somewhere under the brick and steel of a nondescript building, we've once again made contact with our leader, Mark Levin.
Mr. Producer, would you open your mic, please?
He gives a speech after the California victory, and he doesn't say, I reach out to conservatives and Reaganites and the Cruz people. He says, I reach out to the Bernie Sanders supporters because we're closer on trade. Well, I don't support Bernie Sanders on trade. Count me out of this nationalist, populist, agrarian, protectionist, quote, tariffs crowd, because that'll destroy the American economy, American jobs, and put yet another nail in the coffin of capitalism. Then we have others who say, no, we got to back Trump because he's right about the working class, the middle class, and American jobs and protectionism and so forth. These are people who used to support Milton Friedman in the free market process called capitalism. And yet they're underscoring exactly the problem. We can't help the American worker if we embrace progressive policies. We can't help the American worker and American enterprise if we're not conservatives. If we don't advance the conservative cause, constitutionalism, capitalism, individual sovereignty, and so forth and so on. Ivan, Laurel, Maryland, the great WMAL, go.
Is he that stupid, Mark, that he doesn't realize that all he's got to do to get conservatives on his side is to talk about our issues?
I don't think he's stupid at all. I think that his history is one as a liberal. His position on trade is really the position that big labor has had all these decades, and the left. You know, his position on trade is the same as George McGovern's for the most part, the late George McGovern, and he was considered a radical. And I've asked these folks, these surrogates and his people over and over and over again, can you give me a 10-year history where protectionism and tariffs actually created wealth? An opportunity and jobs in this country and brought jobs back from overseas. I'm giving them 10 years, a 10-year period, and they can't. And it's a big problem, no question, Ivan. Always appreciate your call, my friend. We'll be right back. Nathan, Salt Lake City, Utah, the great KKAT. Go!
Yeah, Mark, I was just answering the question you asked about what we conservatives should do, and I tend to favor supporting Donald Trump's America First approach on trade and on immigration, securing the American
His approach on trade is not an American First approach.
Well, it is, and I make the parallel between limited tariffs that Ronald Reagan used to save.
Okay, I've dealt with that, and you know full well I've written about that. But let's focus in. How is protectionism and tariffs American First?
It's not, but that's not his widespread policy.
It is his widespread policy. I've listened to him and so have my listeners.
In his written platform, absolutely not.
I don't care about his written platform. I've heard what he has said, not what somebody else has written for him.
Yeah, so have I. And he's talking about when other countries manipulate their currency and they don't...
But we manipulate our currency. I guess you're aware of quantitative easing?
Well, absolutely, but in the realm of trade, that's
going to... Well, I'm not talking about the realm of trade. You talked about you're bouncing around, and this is what I find. This is why you're unpersuasive, and so many of you are unpersuasive. Every country manipulates its currency. Every single one. We manipulate it the most through the Federal Reserve. The Federal Reserve, which I have huge problems with. The purpose of the Federal Reserve when it was first founded was to have a stable currency. That's not what the Federal Reserve does. The Federal Reserve has kept interest rates as close to zero now for almost a decade for the purpose of making money easier for people to borrow, for jacking up Wall Street, for jacking up the stock market, and for allowing Barack Obama to spend us into oblivion. Don't tell me about currency manipulation. Nobody does it better than the Federal Reserve. So what do you mean? Is that America First?
No, but...
Well, let me ask you another question about America First. You know, there's millions of people in this country that have jobs as a result of imports. Imports. Mechanics. Car dealers and sellers. Others. They get real grease and dirt under their fingernails, depending on what their jobs are. Millions of people in this country rely on imports in order to feed their families. Is it America First to cut them off by driving these businesses out? By putting 45% or 35% or whatever the tariff is today or yesterday or the next day? By raising taxes on goods? By people who are working two part-time jobs? Or they can't find a job at all, driving up their costs? Is that America first?
Not the way you describe it, no.
No, not the way I describe it, but that's reality. Let me ask you something. Aren't 12,000 tariffs enough? We have over 12,000 tariffs we place on goods and services, and most of them are put there through legislation by politicians. What we need to do, sir, is try a little bit of free market capitalism. That's the problem we have today. We know what we can do. You want to talk about Reagan? Reagan went Harley Davidson, steel, computer chips. You're exactly right. Everybody knows that. That's history. But he also vetoed several protectionist bills involving textiles and shoes and copper and other things that was pushed by Congress. And each time and every time, he spoke about free market capitalism, free trade. One of his closest economic advisors, and he was an adherent of it, was Milton Friedman. Now, Milton Friedman is about as free market as they get, as far as I'm concerned, as far as I know. The problem in this country, Nathan, isn't capitalism. We barely practice capitalism anymore. It's under attack with regulations, with taxes, and all the rest of it. To embrace a position that has been pushed by big labor, to embrace a position that has been pushed by every left-wing politician running for president under the Democrat banner, and then say it's America first, is a disaster. You want America first? You grow the economy. You create millions of jobs. You expand wealth creation. And who did it? Reagan did it. Did he do it through tariffs and protectionism? No. Slash taxes across the board. Slash taxes for corporations. Slashed regulations. He even created what is today conservative talk radio by slashing the control of radio by the central government. Nathan, what we need to do is start to embrace liberty, because we, the American people, if we have a little bit more liberty, we will make it. If the government's smaller and gets out of our way, we will make it. The reason why Carrier is shutting down that company in Northern America, in the United States, is because of the Environmental Protection Agency. How do we know that? They told us it. They can't keep having the EPA every year or every other year screw around with their manufacturing. So I think it's a grave disservice that some people do when they say America first means killing capitalism. America first means killing millions of jobs that are involving with imports. That America first means mouthing the same thing that big labor has mouthed all these years. Thank you for your call, sir. Thank you for your call.